Hi there, I'm Herbie. Now you might wonder why I've got some wine glasses sitting in front of me, but the reason is I'm going to talk to you about saffron and how you can tell the real from the fake. Believe it or not, saffron is one of the world's most expensive commodities. It's often around about the same value as gold. You could say that at the moment, good quality saffron has a street value which is nearing $20,000 a kilo. And part of the reason for that is that saffron comes from the stigma of an autumn flowering crocus. Every flower only has three stigma. These are all plucked by hand and then dried. And if you have around about 5 acres of saffron growing, your annual harvest, if you're lucky, might be as much as 1 kilo. Now, when a commodity is as expensive as this, it is very tempting to not only adulterate it, but also to falsify it. And one of the things that I've noticed travelling around the world, and even in Australia, there is a tremendous amount of fake saffron starting to appear on the market. Now, how do you know if saffron is real or not? Because it's this little thread, this little stigma, in the old days, what people would often do is take corn silk, cut it into saffron lengths, dye it, and make it look like saffron. They would also take coconut fibre and do the same thing. In more recent times, what we have seen in markets in Egypt, in Morocco, in India, and as I mentioned, even in Australia, we have seen this fake saffron. And the fake saffron is made of a sort of gelatin-like substance. How do you tell the real thing? True saffron, you will notice, is a short thread, which is almost trumpet-shaped. And that's because, as I mentioned, it's the female organ of the flower, the stigma. And if a saffron thread is dead straight, it is often not the real thing. The other way that you can tell with saffron is when you smell it. True, good quality saffron will have a very woody aroma. It's a very pleasing sort of aroma, but it's a little bit woody with almost a slight little bit of background bitterness in the fragrance. The fake saffrons, funnily enough, they tend to be putting some sandalwood in there. When you smell them, they've got to smell very like sandalwood. Now, when it comes to the actual thing, real saffron, when you put it into water, you take a few stigmas. And the other thing is about saffron, a lot of people use a lot more than they need to in cooking. You really only need about a dozen stigmas to adequately colour and flavour a cup of rice. So don't use too much. Don't believe all the chefs who get a great big handful and go foom into the dish like that. Not necessary. Even a big pinch is not necessary. You can really count out the stigmas. Now, this is a true Kashmiri saffron. And when you put it into the water, you'll notice that the colour doesn't come out straight away. It's a very gradual process. The colouring content in saffron is a water-soluble dye. And that's why it's always a good idea to infuse saffron in a little warm water before you add it to a dish. You can gradually see that it's turning a golden colour. When you take some of the fake saffron and you put that into water, one of the things that you will often notice is that the colour will actually happen a lot more quickly, and the colour will be more red than it is a golden sunny yellow. So if we look here, for instance, at one I prepared earlier, here's a fake saffron that has been infused for several hours. And you can see it's a very orangey, a sort of almost red sort of colour. Here is a true Kashmiri saffron that I've infused for about 15 to 20 minutes. Now, what you'll notice with that one is that it's a really golden yellow colour. I often like to liken it to the colour of sunshine. It is truly beautiful. You can see there's a very big difference. The other thing is that the fake saffron has tended to go a little bit cloudy. And then, what's the final way to tell? This is really interesting. You take a thread from the fake saffron, take one out that's been there, because you'll still see some there, and rub it in between your fingers. You will find that it will dissolve completely. It disappears. Now, saffron is the stigma of a flower. It does not dissolve. It will not disappear. Yes, the colouring will gradually leach out of it as it's infused, but it doesn't dissolve. I'm always a little bit worried when I see a recipe where someone says, dissolve the saffron threads. I think, well, if they're dissolving them, maybe they weren't using the real thing. You can always tell with that, just that little rubbing between the fingers, that dissolves, and then you know it's the fake saffron. Sadly, a lot of people who even sell this product don't really know the real thing. At Herbie's, we have two grades of saffron. We have the Kashmiri whole stigma, and we pack these in a little half gram pack because you really only need such a small amount. There are literally hundreds and hundreds of stigmas in this pack. The Kashmiri saffron is the best quality. It's a nice big stigma, lots of colour, lots of flavour. The other variety that we have is an Iranian saffron. We also have half a gram in a packet. The Iranian saffron is a little shorter. The stigmas are not quite as large as the Kashmiri ones. You'll often see quite a few are broken. The other thing about the Iranian saffron is when you smell it, you'll notice the aroma is a little bit more floral than it is with the Kashmiri. The Kashmiri is more the sort of really true saffron aroma, but a lot of people do like the fragrance of the Iranian saffron, because that slightly floral fragrance goes very well with the sorts of dishes that it would be used in. You will also notice the Iranian saffron tends to be a little more brittle. This can be quite a good thing, because we always say to people, never buy saffron powder. But if you have a recipe that calls for, say, a pinch of saffron powder, take some of the Iranian saffron and either crush that in a pestle and mortar, or even just crush it between a couple of spoons until it's broken up and almost a powder, and then add it to the dish. It will do the job very nicely. And in the last 2.5 years, we have had the price of saffron actually double twice. So yes, it is a very expensive spice, but used sparingly, it's still excellent value for money. And also being very, very wary of the fake saffrons, because you will find that they really don't do the job as effectively. We can have a look now at this one that's been the other fake saffron that's been infusing for only a few minutes since I've been talking. And even now you can see it's a much redder sort of colour. When you smell it, it really doesn't smell of anything in particular. Whereas when you smell the true saffron, it's this lovely, deep, woody note. I always say, enjoy using saffron. Remember the little rule, only use about a dozen stigmas to colour or flavour a cup of rice. Infuse it for 10 or 15 minutes before you add it to the dish. That way you get the best flavour. If you want to purchase our saffron, or you require any more information about herbs and spices, please contact us at Herbie's Spices. Go to our website, which is herbies.com.au. You will find lots of useful information there. We'll be right back.